Now, members of the Syrian National Council, the opposition group in Syria, also present here. This is Mr. Bahoun Kalyun, who's speaking now. Let's listen to him.
Friends of the Syrian people, for their relentless support of the fair and just cause of the Syrian people. Allow me that I will not be speaking only on behalf of the National Council, but also on behalf of people who are meeting bullets with their bare chest in defense of their freedom and dignity, on behalf of the martyrs who have sacrificed their lives for their homeland, on behalf of the orphaned children, bereaved mothers, raped women, and oppressed elderly, on behalf of the injured, the missing, the displaced, and the detained, on behalf of millions of honest, free, struggling Syrian people who are struggling and will continue to struggle this oppressor regime in the cities, towns, villages, and neighborhoods of Syria nationwide. Friends of the Syrian people, since the first conference held in Tunisia in February and today's conference in Istanbul, the Syrian people have offered more blood and more sacrifice on their journey towards freedom and dignity in their struggle to topple a fascist regime, to establish a plural democratic state where the regime is perpetrating killing among civilians, destroying property, and occupying the homeland. The trust towards our people and the responsibility of the Council demand me that I speak to you in absolute veracity that the outcome regionally and internationally has not been tantamount to the amount of sacrifice by the people or violation by the regime. I wouldn't be exaggerating if I say the outcome of our efforts have encouraged the regime to continue killing and allege false victory. Time is opportune for the international and Arab community that we in the Syrian National Council and the opposition embark on our people. We also bank on the Arab international community to provide assistance. It is a very substantial factor in shifting the balance of power. No one can downplay the support provided to the regime by certain regional and international states which encourage the regime to continue its violation. Over the past months, we have heard some stances speaking of growing terrorism in Syria. And here I'm telling you that the democracy for which people are fighting is the enemy of terrorism. If the regime continues in power, it is through terrorism. The Arab international community cannot remain hesitant in the face of what you witness. Tragic scenes from Syria, corner to corner. This must change simply for the reason that the dictator regime is not only posing a danger to the Syria and the Syrian people, it is also a danger to the future of the Arab world, the region, and the whole world. The Syrian revolution, as you are aware, is faced with grave challenges as the regime of Assad dynasty has turned a blind eye to any diplomatic initiative which enable the Syrian people to restore their lawful demands. Exhausted all forms of violence to put an end to the popular revolution that has undermined its seat of power, and it will no doubt topple the regime. The regime is benefiting by the division among the international community, continuing to kill innocent civilians, destroy residential areas, and depriving the people from all livelihood in order to throttle at birth the revolution. And in the face of these grave challenges, the Syrian National Council, since its formation in November 2011, has been working on four pillars. First, to support the peaceful demonstrations expressing the Syrian people's aspiration to freedom, dignity, and building of a democratic state whereby all people are equal in rights and obligations. Secondly, with the subsequent defection by the army, the Syrian National Council endeavored to organize the Free Syrian Army, put it under one command in order to provide protection to unarmed civilians. And the Syrian National Council will provide fixed salaries to all the defecting officers, soldiers, and active fighters. Third, rallying international support, reinforcing cooperation with friendly states and organizations. And the Syrian National Council, fourthly, has worked towards unifying the opposition, reinforcing their confidence, and making it an effective force internally and internationally. Many of you said in the past that the opposition is divided. Their goals are vague and ambiguous, yet the opposition is advancing, crystallizing uniform objectives. A few days ago, under the invitation by the Syrian National Council, a conference was held encompassing all the parties of the opposition, whereby it was agreed to restructure the Syrian National Council. Also, the document of a national pledge has been endorsed to stand as the foundation of New Syria, the new democratic state of Syria as aspired. It states Syria is a civil, democratic, sovereign state whose future is shaped only by the Syrian people, where sovereignty is in the hands of the people to be exercised through democracy. The interim government that to be formed upon the fall of the regime will be responsible for holding free, transparent elections, whereby a constituency committee will be formed to draft a new constitution to be put to the people for referendum. New Syria is a democratic republic based on constitutional equality and the rule of law, whereby all citizens are equal, regardless of their religious, ethnic, racial, or ideological affiliation. Respect of human rights in the state and society represent the cornerstone of democracy in the fledgling Syria. The Constitution does not discriminate any of the components of the social fabric of the Syrian people, including Arab, Assyrian, Kurds, Turkmen, and other minorities. The National Council has reiterated in Tunisia document, and it reiterates that it is committed to recognize the Kurdish ethnicity and to deem the Kurdish cause as part and parcel of the national cause, to lift injustice, compensate the aggrieved, and recognize the rights of the Kurdish people based on the territorial integrity of the people and homeland. The government to be elected will ensure the independence of the judiciary, freedom of individuals and societies, respect human rights and international treaties, ensuring women's rights and freedom, preserving all the gains earned by the Syrian people and by women, ensuring equality with men in all fields. The new state will ensure the rights of all religious groups, ensuring the freedom of religious freedom. It will be subject to the political authority, and it will not intervene in the political life. Security apparatuses will be rebuilt on constitutional and democratic fashion to serve the homeland and citizens under the legislative authority. Laying the foundation of democracy cannot be coupled with any desire for retaliation. On the contrary, the new government will work towards protecting individuals, groups, and societies, ensuring national reconciliation based on tolerance. New Syria will take its position among states, whereby mutual interest and mutual positive constructive cooperation will be the headline of its regional and international dealings, and it will always remain on the side of the international law, security, and peace in the world. Syria will restore its effective role in the region under the umbrella of the Arab League to be a factor of stability in the region, deepening cooperation and solidarity among the Arab states and neighboring countries. New Syria will work towards restoring the occupied Golan Heights with all lawful means, support the Palestinian people in their struggle to restore their established rights and establish their sovereign independent state, and work towards the unity of the Palestinian people. The new Syria will reinforce economic freedom, moving forward economic efforts, justice, and equal opportunities. It will fight poverty, corruption, illiteracy, and unemployment. You, friends of the Syrian people, we are telling you that people cannot relent. They will continue to struggle, providing a legendary model of the Arab Spring. We call on you to form a diplomatic vision reflecting your solidarity. Yes, we need immediate relief aid. Yes, we need safe passage. Yes, we need support to the Free Syrian Army to provide protection to civilians. Yes, we need recognition of the Syrian National Council as the sole lawful representative of the Syrian people in their struggle towards freedom. Yes, we need an international commitment to the rebuilding of Syria destroyed by the regime once the regime inevitably falls. This is what we want, and this is what we need to see materializing swiftly. We thank your support. However, we demand more. We demand serious action. The Syrian regime will inevitably fall. Don't prolong the catastrophe. The revolution will triumph. Don't allow people to continue to suffer. The opposition is united. Now it's time for you to unite and side with the opposition. The Syrian people cannot forget those who support it, as it does cannot forget those who oppose it. We salute the Arab Spring and all the pride to the revolution, glory to the martyrs. Long live Syria, free and defiant.